Level 40, you're like perfect. Yeah, come here, guys. All right, I gotta put everybody in passive. Passive, passive, passive. Nobody do anything. You can poop. Yes, Meg, you can poop. And whammo! Right on top. Oh, I'm in it. Sorry. Watch your tail, dude. And so, Paulina Punchwood, the heroine of our story, mother of dinos, friend of the rodents, and now proud owner of an economical hybrid vehicle with low emissions, great gas, and well, just not a lot of trunk space, but still pretty comfortable and a pretty good drive. Terrabird Meg here. So there we have it. Welcome back, everybody, to Ark Survival Evolved, Scorched Edition, Scorched Earth Edition. And oh, look, your skin is so smooth again, Humphrey. I don't know how he does it. Again, I think it's the cactus sap. But anyway, yeah, so welcome back. We have a lovely day ahead of you today. I'm actually going to be taming a Limantria today. That's the moth, the big flying moth feller. And that's because we need some wings so we can get around a little better. I know, right? I know, right? I just got a new car, but now I need wings. So I think we're all ready to go, but let me just show you around the new place before we go. So I've spent a lot of time working on the adobe shelter here, making the adobe walls and other structural pieces. It's really a pain in the butt, but we're making slow progress, slow but steady. So there it is on the outside. And let's go on inside. I got a lovely fireplace now. This thing is amazing. It warms this place up at night. It's nice and toasty in here. In the day, it gets a little hot. So we'll just leave that running right now because... Oh, we have a new friend. Salamander. This is a female Lystrosaurus, right? Yeah, Lystrosaurus. When I saw her from up above on Humphrey's back, she looked like a tiny little salamander that I used to catch as a kid. So that's why we call her Salamander. Anyway, let's go on up here, and I'll show you the new third floor and the new second floor. I've got all of Paulina's, cabinets in here, wardrobes, etc. So that looks nice. We climb up here to the third floor, open up that trap door, and here we go, up into Paulina's bedroom, which is right here. There's a bed, obviously, and she even has a little walkout deck. Very lovely. All right, well, that's pretty much it. All right, so now we are ready, I think, to go try to find one of these Limantrias. Let me just double check, make sure I have everything we need. Yeah, it looks like we have everything we need, guys, with the exception of chitin and keratin in order to make the Limantria saddle. But Paulina has met the requirements of level 45 while I was here working, and that's one of the reasons I want to go do this today. Now, we don't have a lot of time today, unfortunately, because I'm getting prepared to go on a trip to go see my daughter in college. And it's been a few months since I've seen her, so I'm very excited. She's a freshman in college this year. I have not seen her in a few months. We dropped her off at the end of August, a little bit earlier than the regular students because she's an athlete. She's playing field hockey. And so, yeah, it's been a few months. That's the longest time I've not seen her since, I don't know, maybe 3 or 4 years ago. She went away for a week at overnight camp. So what we're looking for is, well, we need keratin, and we need or chitin. And I'm pretty sure we can get that stuff from saber-toothed tigers. Even ankylosauruses. Oh, there's one right now. Yeah, I don't know. This could get pretty messy here in the busy freeway, so I don't know if we're going to do this. Because if we attack this ankylosaurus, we're going to probably anger everybody else on the road. They're just, you know, trying to get to work. So, you know what? Forget about it. Let's go over here. We can get keratin and chitin from thorny dragons, too. Excuse me. Beep, beep. You know what? Let's do this the other way. This is why I bought Meg. Let's go. Yeah, here we go. Come in, Humphrey. He's not far behind. Look at that. So much more efficient. The biggest issue with Meg here is that she can't carry a lot, so I gotta go light. All right, Humphrey, come on over here. Fill up on some water. Oh, you drink it over there? Oh, no, 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 look at that. Don't drink out of that puddle. Come over here, where there's fresh water. Big water. Here we go. Fill it up, pal. Fill it up. Let Humphrey fill up, and then we'll go hunt. Oh, there's a Lamantrian right there. I wonder what level. So I looked up on the taming calculator, and these things actually take quite a bit of time to tame without the right food. So they love a thorny dragon kibble, but unfortunately I don't have any of that. So we're gonna have to go with Mejo berries. And with Mejos, it takes about a half an hour for a level 50 tame. Yeah, level 50. So I'm gonna try to keep it around that level because I don't really have time to do anything higher. All right, we have a target right here with a bit of some goodness that we need. A little level 4. Go on, Meg. Take him down. Look at Meg go. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Oh, no, Meg, let me... Oh, I want to get the keratin off that thing. I think the best tool... Oh, you're beautiful. Level 40, you're like perfect. Yeah, come here, guys. All right, I got to put everybody in passive. Passive, passive, passive. Nobody do anything. You can poop. Yes, Meg, you can poop. Oh, no, 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 come back. No, no, no. Oh, 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 oh. Go down. Come down. Come down. Oh, dread. This is why I brought the Ebolas, because we got to get them down first. All right, just stand still, would you? Okay, and now I've got the bow with some arrows, and we're going to try to knock them out without killing them. Wait a few seconds here. Each bullet holds them for 30 seconds. Let's get one more shot with the arrow. I guess they're pretty easy to kill like this, so let's replenish that. Look at those little tentacles. Yucky. He's doing his little spray thing. Oh, no, 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 hey! Oh, dang it. I walked right into it. Come on, I hit him with the thing. That's me. Thought I got him with the Ebola. There he goes, up in the... Oh, way up high. I'm never gonna get him now. Yeah, come on back down. Come on back down. Oh, man, I love those blue wings. Well, there he is. There he is, way up top again. Come down here. So beautiful. Oh, there he is. He's coming down. Come on, guys. Let's get the Ebolas out. That's following. Yep, there he is again. All right, let's try this again. Is that him? Hold on. No, you're not the right one. Those purple wings. Let's bring that scorpion in here. There he comes. There he comes. You're right. That's right. You challenge. Get him, guys. Boom! And grab some berries while we're at it. Come on, Meg. Where are you? You involved in this? Oh, you know what? They're passive. I forgot. Alright, get the axe. Axe is the right tool for this. Oh, look at all that chitin. 56. Great. Halfway there. We still have to pick a bird. Pick a Lamantrian. It's right there behind us. You're back. You really want to come live with the mother of dinos, don't you? It's pretty obvious. And just get down here. We can be friends. Alright, got him. Let's try this again. Number 8. 1. I don't want to do this too fast. Just have to remember to switch to the Ebola real quick. So I guess my first Ebola... The second Ebola didn't seem to work on him for some reason. That was weird. Alright, come on, we can do this. Oh! Alright, guys, I think we're gonna have to set our sights much lower than I was hoping. Oh, you're back. Oh, that's a level 4. It's kind of beautiful, actually. But this one right here is a level 12. I think we can take out the level 12 without too much trouble. Clearly, this is more complicated and time-consuming than I was expecting and hoping for. So, level 12 it is, at least, I think, anyway. The problem is, these Ebolas, once the first one goes poof, you have to hit it immediately following the second one. And you can't put a second one on it while it's still under. Oh, guys. 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 Guys, help me out here. You take care of that. I'm working. Working here. I gotta get that Ebola out. Quick, 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 quick. And get, oh, get him. Oh, did I get him? Oh, so close. Thanks for the backup. Oh, drat. Level 12. All right, he's gonna fall out of the sky, I guarantee it. There he is, he's coming down, he's coming down, coming down. Does this mean I have to go lower than level 12? I don't really want to do that. Oh, because I think, yeah, the lower we get, the less weight capacity they're gonna have, obviously. Where are you headed, fella? I don't think I've ever been over here before. This is uncharted territory for Paulina. Oh, no, no. This is bad news over here. Lots of predators. Is that him over there? Oh, here he comes. Hi. Remember me? He's a little dazed from the drugs, I think. Ready? And whammo! Right on top. Oh, I'm in it. It's alright. Watch your tail! Dude! One. Oh, look at Meg down there hopping around. Two. Three. We got him! Woohoo! Alright, put that thing down. Wait, it's alive, right? Alright, Meg, get up here. I need you. Cover me. Level 12. Big orangey eyes. It's a she, actually. Nice. What do you think, Cleo? Alright, let's take a look at this moth's trunk space. 185? Wow! That's a bigger trunk than you came with, Meg. Meg's at 184, even after leveling up Meg a few times. Okay. Well, we really only need it for scouting, mostly, but that's pretty good. I can carry quite a bit of stuff at 185, plus we'll level up a little bit. So I guess I don't feel too badly about having such a low-level moth. Level 12. Still looking around. I'm not giving up. This is that level 40 with the blue wings over there. Oh, man. Well, if he comes closer, I might try to take him down. Otherwise, I'm just going to go with this one right here. All right, so I'm just going to do my thing here, guys. I'm just going to wait a little while, and then we're going to give her some mejo berries. And in the meantime, I think I might go hunt. I need just a few more chitin. Okay, we're at 67 right now, so that's one or two more kills. It shouldn't be too difficult. Maybe I'll take Meg for a ride. Yeah, Meg, let's go kill somebody. And Humphrey, I want you to watch our moth friend here. Okay, a little girl here looks like she's going to be fine for a few minutes, so let's leave her there, let her get hungry, and then we'll give her a bunch of berries when we get back. Now, I want to show you something. This is really cool. This is added in the latest patch. We can now put weapons in our hands while mounted, so we can fight on horseback, or turkeyback, or whatever you happen to be on, I suppose. Now, hold up. We have a terror bird up ahead, level 20. Yeah, we can take him down easily enough. In fact, let's just bring him in, and then we'll pummel him. Here he comes. Smile for the crossbow! Alright, Meg. I don't want to shoot Meg in the head, that's the only thing. Let's get him. Meg, you want some? Aw, alright, let's go get him. Oh! Get him, Meg, get him! Nice. Now, terror birds don't give chitin or anything, do they? Oh, I can't switch to third person view with the weapon in my hand when mounted, though. Oh, that's too bad. All right, I'm going to hop off. And Meg's going to have a snack. Okay. I'll take the arrows. Thank you very much. Don't need the berries. And I should reload. There we go. All right, we want chitin or keratin, don't we? Oh, there we go. This is a perfect target. Let's just check the level. Just to be on the safe side. Oh, this is the little baby girl. No problem! Hopefully there's no big brother or papa over here. Oh, get up there, birdie. Let's draw him in. Bring him over this way. There's one shot, two shots. Here come the spikes. He missed. Oh, I did all the killing. All right, now, I don't want you to get involved. Hold on. This is what I want you to do. Not eat that. What did I say? Hold. This is my kill. I need the keratin. There we go. Good Meg. Man. All right, you can be neutral again. She listens well. That's what I like about my little vehicle here. Okay. So we can make the saddle now. Oh, look at this, man. She's sleeping like a rock. Perfect. And there we go, guys. Lemantria saddle. Got everything we need. Just bang it out. Thanks for the ride, Meg. Oh, your beak is so smooth. You're using the same stuff that Humphrey's been using, huh? You're not going to share your secrets with Paulina, though, are you? Her skin could use a little... Oh, no, her skin's good, too. All right, never mind. Oh. Ooh, it doesn't last very long, though. Cactus sap, that's the secret. I think we'll be okay with the 185 weight limit right now, because that's actually going to rise when we when she's tamed and we level her up a little bit. Oh, another terror bird over there. Looking for his long-lost buddy. All right, we're going to wait a little bit longer here. And then we're going to dump a whole bunch of berries to get the highest level possible. Pretty sure that's how that works. So stay tuned, I'll be right back. Hopefully this doesn't take too long. Let me see, actually at level 12, we're looking at about 17 minutes. Okay, that's about half of what it was gonna take for the 50 that I had anticipated hunting for, so good. We're right on schedule. Even better than right on schedule. What do you think, Paulina? She ready? She's ready. Okay, we got the okay from the mother of dinos. She knows what she's talking about. She's been through this before, so. All right, yeah, let's grab the berries. We have lots and lots of berries. It shouldn't take very many, according to the taming calculator. 13? 13 berries? Maybe all at once? Let's see. Let's see. Go ahead, girl. Eat them up. Nom nom. Oh, you're so hungry. Come on. All 22? Better grab some more just in case. Just in case. I don't want her to run out and then hate Paulina. There you go. Lots more for you. Oh my. Oh dear. You have an appetite. Sheesh. Little guy has an appetite, Meg. Oh wow. That was awesome. I've never done that before. Instant tame. Okay, that was pretty cool. And of course you know what name we're going to give our big moth friend here, don't you? There's only one possible name for giant moth. Mothra! As a big fan of monster movies when I was a kid, and, well, actually, still am, Mothra versus Godzilla is got a lot of real estate in my brain still. I'll never forget that movie. Look at you, level 17. Let's check out the weight. Oh, 185. Okay, it didn't actually go up on its own. So, yeah, sorry, Mothra. I gotta take some of your berries away and give them back to the big fella over here. Oh, he's fine. Never mind. But we don't really need all those. We don't want to carry too much weight. Okay, in fact, I'm gonna shed some weight, and I'm gonna fly on Mothra back home. I want everyone to follow me. Everybody's gonna follow me now. Okay, we're gonna race on home before the nightfall. There we go. It's a perfect fit, Mothra. Guys, check her out. She's beautiful. Oh, I love it. Okay, so you guys, you know the way home, right? Okay, I'll see you there. Hold up. Oh, woo. Look at her. It's amazing. Oh, I love her little noises. She's so fast. Well, no, she's not that fast. But it's a smooth ride. Yeah, we got air suspension. Oh, Mothra, you're the best! The best! Better than that level 68. I'm gonna want him anyway, or her, whatever the heck it was. Oh, this is great. We'll go low. We'll fly low so Meg and Humphrey can keep up. Now, we're gonna see how fast we can go. Oh, you wanna drop a load? Jettison some weight! There we go. We want a good gauge here of how fast she is. She's pretty quick. That's not bad. That's not bad. That'll keep us out of most trouble. All right, this is great, guys. I'm super happy that we have our moth now. Now we can do some serious scouting, and we'll check out the rest of this map and see what's up. But we gotta get everybody else home at first. Oh, look who it is! Level 40, whatever. Look at this, purple! Purple wings, he's awesome. All of you could have been something, but now you're nothing. You're just wild, crazy, feral moths. You could have had the mother of dinos riding on your backs, jerks. Alright, enough taunting, let's get home. The best thing about Mothra, yes, that's right, Humphrey. The best thing about Mothra is, well, when she's got a full tank of gas, she is able to fly right over the freeway. Oh, I love that sound Mothra makes, echoing in the canyon. Oh, look at her little proboscis. The sharp thing in her face. But she can, oh my gosh, we just guess Humphrey and Meg behind us. It's like a James Bond car. Press a button and the gas comes out. I wonder if we can drop like sharp tacks and give him flat tires. Hey buddy, check this out. Oh, somebody leveled up. Who's that? Is that you for gassing people? Oh, it is. Nice. Well, you know what we're going to do. We're going to give her some extra weight. That's pretty good. All right, Mothra, keep going. We're almost home. I love the dust she kicks up when she takes off. Hey. Who's this stranger over here? Oh, it's one of Humphrey's pals. Yeah, we're back. You guys can play now. And Mothra. Oh, actually, everybody stay. I'm going to put Mothra right up on top. And crawl around a little too, just like a moth. Oh, she's sticky too. All right, right here. Right here, you can look in Pauline's window, okay? At your new mommy. And with that, my friends, we're going to have to call it quits. Sorry, Humphrey. Yes, we do. We have to go. I need to go. I got to go pack so I can visit my daughter in college. I already said that earlier. I got lots to do. So we'll just have to pick up here next time, and I'll try to make up for it in the future. Anyway, goodbye, everybody. We'll see you. Goodbye, Paulina. We're going to head inside and get a nice fire going, I think. Yeah, let's get a fire going. All right, off the back. Get out. Oh, what are we doing? Hi, Salamander. How you doing? Good to see you. Pet Salamander. Give her a little extra health, and then spark up the flames. Oh, that's so good. It's going to be a cold night, I hear.